streets every time. A man will kill you for less than a dime. Now I sit and let them take away mine. Scratch my warming sun, walk on chalk line. Out a road, man, I flex when leave. Them see where you drive, them nothing know where you sleep. Food and feed eat when the Sabbath I keep. They never know, say, Bobo healing so steep.
Okay, so I thought I'd break away from the on-screen commentary and add some narration to my thoughts on the Americans for the last 5 years of my viewing and the last 6 years overall. Now, I began regularly watching the Americans in year two and was so impressed by what I saw that I decided to purchase year one and binge watch it all the way through in what effectively amounted to a little under 24 hours. Boy, let me tell you, what a season. What a season. I mean, the combinations of intrigue, nuance, attention to detail, and character development all got me hooked, and I was really glad that I decided to give it a shot by catching up with year one and then following the show to conclusion. Now, as many of you know, The Americans ended its brilliant six-year run this past Wednesday, June 30th of this year, 2018. Overall, I was pleased by the finale. Perhaps some things could have been done differently, but generally it was an emotionally satisfying and, yes, to me, tragic ending for Philip and Elizabeth Jennings. Now, spoiler alert for those of you who have not seen the finale, nobody died, including our KGB husband and wife team, neither of their kids, nor anyone from the FBI, but we'll talk more about the series finale at a little bit later time. At this point, what I'd like to do is set the stage for the next phase of my commentary, because a little background may assist non-fans to get a grasp of the series a bit better. The Americans is a period piece set in 1980s America and focuses centrally on the historical era known as the Cold War, the standoff between what was then the Western Alliance as led by the United States and international communism as then led by Russia. Philip and Elizabeth Jennings are two Russian spies implanted by the KGB into the U.S. They are both recruited at very young ages to serve their country, and then sent undercover to America posing as an average everyday married couple. Now, on the global stage, the series occurs during the administration of U.S. President Ronald Reagan and Soviet premiers Leonid Brezhnev and Yuri Andropov. It culminates in its final year with the rapprochement between Ronald Reagan and Russian General Secretary Mikhail Gorbachev in 1987. Now, this also coincides with the coming fall of the Berlin Wall in 1989 and the collapse of communism internationally in 1991. Now, these events are not depicted in the closing episodes of The Americans, but conscientious students of history will recognize their imminent occurrence in the real-world historical timeline. They will also recognize the role, however minor or tangential, that Philip and Elizabeth played in bringing some of these events to fruition. The genesis of the August coup, as it is historically referred to, of 1991 against Mikhail Gorbachev is showcased in the series' final year, but the coup itself is not dramatized. Now, with respect to Philip and Elizabeth, they are both highly trained expert operatives of the KGB. Their skill sets include infiltration, recruitment, psychological manipulation, and self-defense. They know the art of killing well. And they are both adroit users of sexpionage, that is, the use of human sexuality as a weapon of warfare and subversion. Now, throughout the life of the series, both Philip and Elizabeth's training as KGB officers is often portrayed, and this is in the context of demonstrating not only their own masterful and often deadly abilities with this training, but also how serious the KGB took its officers' mastery of these skills. And if any of you know anything about the history of the Committee for State Security, the KGB, then you know it had a fearsome reputation for ruthlessness and dedication to the maintenance and advance of communism worldwide, but particularly inside Mother Russia. In fact, Vladimir Lenin, the founder of the communist state, called it the sword and shield of the Bolshevik Revolution of 1917. And this statement of purpose is embodied in the very emblem of the KGB itself. Okay? So, this solemn commitment to worldwide Russian and, by broader extension, communist ambitions is exemplified in the spouse-spy relationship of Philip and Elizabeth, and I dare say, especially in the case of Elizabeth.